Hello, I'm Sebastian. Welcome to Nine Not Trees podcast. Today I will summarize and review the book. In the Happiness Project 10th Anniversary Edition, Gretchen Rubin embarks on a year-long journey to discover what leads to true happiness. Initially published 10 years ago, this edition adds a fresh perspective and new insights to Rubin's quest. Armed with zeal and a keen sense of inquiry, Rubin sets out to test the theories of ancient philosophy, current psychology, and pop culture about how to lead a happier life. Her experiment involves setting monthly goals that target various aspects of her daily life, from her relationships and career to her attitude towards money, spirituality, and leisure. Throughout the book, Rubin's narrative is both deeply personal and universally applicable, turning the reader's attention towards their own opportunities for finding joy in the mundane and reinforcing the idea that happiness is indeed a work in progress. I will give you key takeaways from this book. Firstly, the importance of self-knowledge in pursuing happiness. Gretchen Rubin's journey begins with the foundational step of understanding oneself, which she identifies as a crucial element in the pursuit of happiness. Rubin emphasizes that self-knowledge is the tool that enables us to identify what truly brings us joy, rather than what we're told should make us happy. This involves introspection and occasionally challenging societal norms or expectations. For example, Rubin experiments with different activities and hobbies, reflecting on how they affect her mood and well-being. She also talks about identifying true rules or personal commandments that guide her towards making decisions that align with her genuine self. This topic underscores the premise that happiness is a personal journey, and what works for one person may not work for another, highlighting the importance of understanding and honoring oneself in the happiness equation. Secondly, the role of relationships in happiness. Rubin swiftly moves on to the realm of interpersonal relationships, asserting their central role in cultivating happiness. She delves into the dynamics of her marriage, friendships, and family connections, testing various strategies to strengthen these bonds. Rubin's experiments include practices such as active listening, showing appreciation, and engaging in meaningful conversations. She explores the balance between giving and taking, the importance of shared experiences, and the impact of positive affirmations on relationships. Throughout this journey, Rubin discovers that happiness is significantly influenced by the quality of our relationships. The Happiness Project thus becomes not just an individual quest, but a communal endeavor, reflecting on the adage that happiness shared is happiness doubled. Thirdly, the power of habits and routines. One of Rubin's key discoveries is the impact of daily habits and routines on overall happiness. She explores how creating positive, consistent routines can lead to a more organized mind and a happier life. Rubin adopts new habits such as decluttering her space, adhering to a regular sleep schedule, and incorporating exercise into her daily routine. Through trial and error, she learns how small changes can lead to significant improvements in her mood and energy levels. This topic is a testament to the idea that while habits may seem mundane, they hold the power to transform our lives by creating a supportive framework for happiness to flourish. Rubin's narrative highlights the psychological benefits of routine, including reduced stress, increased productivity, and a more profound sense of overall well-being. Fourthly, finding joy in everyday life. Central to Rubin's happiness project is the idea of finding joy in the everyday moments. She emphasizes the significance of savoring the small pleasures, practicing gratitude, and adopting a mindful approach to daily life. Rubin experiments with various strategies to enhance her day-to-day experiences, such as keeping a gratitude journal, setting aside time for leisure activities she genuinely enjoys, and creating moments of mindfulness amidst a busy schedule. This exploration sheds light on the concept that happiness often resides in the present moment, and that by cultivating a practice of noticing and appreciating the small everyday occurrences, one can significantly boost their overall happiness. Rubin's experiences serve as a reminder that in the pursuit of grand achievements and milestones, one should not overlook the joy that daily life offers. Lastly, the challenge of change and personal growth. Throughout her year-long project, Rubin confronts the challenge of change and the fears associated with stepping out of one's comfort zone. This topic deals with the psychological barriers to happiness, such as fear of failure, resistance to change, and the discomfort of trying new things. Rubin's personal anecdotes about trying to sing in the morning or fight right with her spouse provide a relatable and human aspect to these challenges. she discusses the importance of embracing imperfection and the growth that comes from facing one's fears. This theme resonates throughout the book as Rubin learns that personal growth and happiness are inextricably linked. Her journey illustrates that overcoming obstacles and embracing change is not only possible but essential for achieving a deeper sense of fulfillment and happiness. In conclusion, Gretchen Rubin's The Happiness Project is a compelling read for anyone on a quest for more joy, understanding, and fulfillment in life. Through her experimental approach to happiness, Rubin provides valuable insights into the practical steps individuals can take to enhance their daily lives. This book is particularly suitable for those who appreciate a blend of personal narrative with actionable advice. Rubin's journey illustrates that happiness is not necessarily about grand gestures or major life changes, but often about refining our daily habits, attitudes, and interactions. Readers looking to embark on their own journey of self-discovery, or those seeking inspiration to make positive changes in their lives, will find Rubin's story both relatable and motivating. Ultimately, The Happiness Project teaches us that the pursuit of happiness is an ongoing process, and that with intentionality and effort, it's possible to cultivate a more joyful and satisfying life. If you would like to support Gretchen Rubin, you can buy the book through the Amazon link I've provided in the podcast description. After reading the book, please let me know what you think and share your thoughts. See you around. Ooh.